Hello, happy Friday, July the 11th. I'm Brian Cullen, and welcome to my Creature Curations. On tonight's adventure, we will be starting on a sculpt for a commission that I'm working on of this dog warrior creature. You can see in the left-hand side of the screen, I have the initial concept sketch, which was approved, and we're going to get started pretty quickly. So I hope everybody that is tuning in tonight is having a good night, and you can hear me crystal clear. If you have any questions along the way, please do not hesitate to ask. So, I'm not putting my gloves on yet because I'm still sipping on a little bit of coffee to try and keep me going throughout the evening. I did a little prep work before starting this evening. I went ahead and drilled a hole through the inside of this styrofoam base that I'm using for the foundation of the sculpture. I cut a dowel rod and also drew out the base of the axe that's going to be in its mouth to give it a foundation that I'm going to sculpt on top of. This is going to have multiple coats of Magic Sculpt on it, one to let it cure and dry and get really hard before I then sculpt back on top of it to give it the detail that it needs. I also went ahead and made the eyes for the creature. Let's see. Let's do it here. So this is the color eyes that they're going to be. Hey there, Fracas Lauren. Fracas Lauren, how are you doing today? So I made two eyes for that, and I've also created ears that I just made out of a rigid board material that I'm going to set in. Now, usually when I start with one of these beasties, I want to kind of sketch out my thoughts as to where the different textures are going to go for the overall sculpting technique. Like because I know the fur that's on the chest, I'm doing awesome. It's good to be back and streaming on Twitch because I took a pretty big hiatus, and I'm excited to be back on here. So thank you for tuning in. And I love making with the sculpting, so it's going to be a good night. So I'm going to just kind of, with a Sharpie, quickly block in the basic areas that I know the chest is going to be a lighter color. But aside from the color, I also want the fur texture. Hey, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. The texture is going to be a little bit different as well, so I want to kind of block that out so that when I don't have to think about it when I'm going into sculpting. Now also, see, I made a little note on the ears that I made right and left when I was drawing these out and cut them out, so I had an idea as to where they were going to go. One of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to cut into the styrofoam base to kind of root this in here just a little bit. So I'm going to mark these off, and then the first thing we're going to do is actually cut directly into the styrofoam base. Then from there we'll get to actually sculpting with the Magic Sculpt. So now this stuff, it's really not that, like, the outside's got a nice hard shell on it, but then once you get into the inside, once you actually cut in, it comes out pretty easily. So for this step, I'm just going to take an X-Acto blade and just kind of do a line. Just gently, whoop, it's a little tough, it's grabbing onto the blade itself. Tighten this up a little bit. And give it a little bit of leverage from up here. Basically, I'm just going to cut into it, and then I'll do some cross cuts, and then we'll just kind of dig it out with like a dentist type tool. Oh, very cool. Well, I use Magic Sculpt, which is a two-part air drying resin, so I won't spend too much time on this pre-work. We'll be getting into the sculpting probably, I would guess, 8 to 10 minutes at max. I just want to give, by putting stuff like this into it, it gives it a foundation of where to go, so it's not just clay that's sitting on top of it. It helps me build the actual form a little bit quicker. And same thing with me using this styrofoam base as my foundation. Having this as the starting point makes it easier to get to the end goal quicker. Do you do any sculpting on your own? Or any form of the arts? And now I'm cutting this hole a little bit bigger than the actual board, but that's okay because I'm gonna fill that in with some of the Magic Sculpt that's gonna hold the earpiece in place. And again, I did mention that I was gonna take this opportunity before I have the gloves on to drink on some coffee. Ah, delicious. Yes, so I love the sculpting, mainly because of the nice tactile experience, actually getting to work with your hands on stuff a little bit more than the painting. Just especially, I'm on the computer a good chunk of the day, so when I get to use my hands on this, it's a nice break from that. All right, let's see. So the tool I'm going to use, now that I've given these cuts into it, where are you, my tool friend? It's going to be almost like a little hook. Let's see. All right. So the tool I'm going to use for this is a little hook. Let's see. Get a little bit closer. Almost looks like a fish hook. And I'm just going to... First, I'm going to go in and get one out with the other side of this tool. Just kind of pop that out. Then from here, I'm just going to fish in and pluck these guys out. Once these are out, it'll be pretty easy to... Luckily, I'm flicking away from my coffee. Now, let's see if that is enough space to put this in. It's got a decent amount, but I'm gonna want to go back a little bit further. I'm gonna dig a little more of this styrofoam out. One thing about the styrofoam, it makes a huge mess on the floor when you're taking away from it as opposed to just adding to it. All right, so taking another little chunk out of it. Let's see. Almost there. One more little cut, and I think that should be good. And that'll give me enough to be able to root that in a little bit. Now I have this on a Lazy Susan because it's going to be easier to turn and twist and sculpt on since it is of a decent size once we get actually moving. All right. Okay, I think that's going to work out well. So that kind of sets that ear in place just for now. And then once we put the magic sculpt on it, that'll root it in. And then that's going to have to dry for this sculpting session. So this sculpture itself will probably take 2 or 3 sculpting sessions. Usually I sculpt about 2 to 3 hour blocks, but the magic sculpt will dry it'll really harden up in about 12 hours. That's usually the minimum I give it for really firming up. So with this, I did the exact same thing as I did on the other ear. I'm gonna see how much more room I need, and I need just about the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut a little bit more into it. Take another swig of coffee real quick. All right. Now, I don't always use these styrofoam bases to start with. Sometimes I make my own foam pieces where I create the forms and cut them out. But I find that starting with some sort of foundation before actually going in and just start sculpting from scratch helps makes the process a lot easier. Okay, so now we've got the ears in place, kind of have the axe in place. Now I want to kind of get an idea for where I'm going to put the eyes, because I'm not going to put them right here in front like they are for the base for this coyote piece. That's what this would be used for. This would be used for taxidermy for a coyote. So I'm going to do them off to the side a little bit. And I'm just giving myself an idea there. That'll help me make sure that when I'm doing the muzzle up here and the upper lip, all right, that I have it rooted in a good place. One more sip of coffee, and then it's time to mix up the magic sculpt. Now, if there's anybody watching that has watched before, I'm sure you've heard this and you'll hear it as I sculpt almost every time. I use Magic Sculpt, a 2-part air-drying epoxy. You mix part A and B together. At equal portions, and it will start to cure when you mix the two portions together. About an hour, it gets to the point where I don't like to work with it anymore. So I buy it in these big 10-pound buckets. I'm opening up the resin part. It's a resin and a hardening agent. Because this is near the bottom of the bucket, I'm going to use just a paint scraping tool to help dig out some of this resin. Grab a little bit out. Gonna grab a little bit more because that's not quite enough for me to really start with. All right, let's see, a little bit more. All right, so we've got a ball about this size. The resin is a lighter gray color. The hardening agent, which I'll grab next, is going to be a little bit slightly darker gray. And I'm gonna try and get pretty close to equal size of the ball of the hardener to the resin. And the reason for that is they ship equally. So I don't run out of one faster than the other. I tend to work that way. If you wanted it to cure a little faster, you could use more hardening agent. If you wanted it to cure a little slower, you could use more resin, but I try to get them relatively close. So now that we have these two balls of Magic Sculpt, you should be able to see that the colors are different with the colors of light and dark gray. I'm gonna take each one, sorry for the sticky sounds. I'm going to pull them into coils. Oops, that one snapped apart. Basically, I'm gonna separate, roll them a little thinner just so I can twine the two together. Inspired by the new lumberjack. Oh, hey, what's happening? Drew, how are you? Yeah, so this was the lumberjack dog is for Dogmite Games. They wanted their logo is a silhouette of a Labrador, so they wanted a dog, but they wanted it all to also have some sort of like orange war paint. So in the illustration, if you see like the markings on its face, those are going to be in orange, but the dog itself is going to be pretty black most likely. And they also wanted it to have some sort of axe in its mouth. So my axe was a little bit, it's got a little more tooth to it as far as the shape. It's a little different because I wanted it to be from my world, Revelo, as to just be a random animal. So this creature will have some sort of backstory. Usually I come up with those after I've sculpted it and once I'm in the painting process. So as you can see, the Magic Sculpt, you can still see the ribbons of the dark gray and the light gray. You want to work this through until they are one uniform color. That way you know everything's mixed well and you're not going to have something that just isn't curing and just sitting there still soft to the touch. Usually I do this about three or four times during a 2-hour stream, depending on how detailed things get and how quickly I'm moving with the Magic Sculpt. Anything new with you today, Drew? All right, this is almost there. All right, so now I can look at the Magic Sculpt. The color is pretty uniform all the way through. There's no, right on. As well, it should be on a Friday, I do believe. So usually the very first thing I like to put in is the eyes, just so I can kind of have it looking at me while I'm going, because it helps give me more of a sense of the character that it's going to become. So I'm going to take just a little bit of the Magic Sculpt. Not a lot, because I just kind of want to set it in. And then have it looking at me. So I'm gonna grab these eyes. I'm gonna try not to touch them too much because I do have Magic Sculpt on the thumbs of my gloves. Even though the Magic Sculpt will come off of the glass with a little bit of scraping, I'm gonna try and get it in areas that I don't have too much Magic Sculpt on it. All right. All right. So I got at least a base there of what it's looking like, and or what the eyes are going to look at me like, and right now it's looking pretty darn kooky, but it will start to come together pretty quickly. The next thing I want to do is I want to root these ears to kind of get them started. So I'm going to just take a little bit of the Magic Sculpt, give out a coil, pinch the coil in half, and make sure I line the edge here of what's getting jammed down into that part that I cut away at. And I'm going to jam it down inside. I'm going to make sure, one of the things with this and why I tend to sculpt in multiple sessions is that eventually I start grabbing onto pieces that are already, that are still kind of soft. And you don't really want to be mashing down on something that's got texture on it already and got good details. So right now it's easy because I'm grabbing onto the neck. Haha, hey Super Scoober. Yes, the eyes just kind of bulging out like that are a little bit creepy. Thank you very much on the eyes. I started making my own eyes sometime over the past year, I guess it was. I used to buy my eyes from a taxidermy shop, and then I realized the eyes couldn't just get weird enough. The colors were all too of this earth, and since I've been building my own world out, I wanted things to feel slightly different. So again, same thing with this ear. I'm putting a little bit of Magic Sculpt on each side so I can jam it down, and that'll harden up real good. And so I designed these eyes on the computer, printed them out, and then after they're printed and in color, I'm now starting to paint over top of them with watercolor to give it a slight translucency and a slight variation, so they're not like, so each one has a little more uniqueness to it. All right. Got the ears in, at least the foundation. Now, so because this is a board material, it's a paper-based thing, I tend to put on a really thin... Thank you very much. Yes, I've started making all the eyes just because they've got to look weird. So I'm going to do a real thin layer of Magic Sculpt on top of the board so that one... Usually I spray it with water to get nice details into it, but I need it to have this on it and dry and hardened before I start doing that. Otherwise, the paper composite underneath will start to fall apart. So I'm just going to do a nice thin layer, and I'll do this on each ear, both the top side and top and underneath. Then I'll probably spray my fingers with a little bit of water to try and help smooth things down just a little bit. But I don't have to worry too much about the details now because these ears will really get finished out in the next sculpting session. Now, it'll be even cooler once we start moving into some of the areas where I can actually put texture in, where I'm not just laying down foundation. But it's good to see these starting points for these pieces and knowing that, yeah, sometimes you just have to be patient and wait a day before you can go back and add the details to this chunk. Hold it by the snout, knowing that there is no Magic Sculpt on there yet. So after we get the ears taken care of, I'll probably move on to the axe to put some of the foundation down there, because I need to make sure that that is held in place firmly. And then we'll start moving into like building out the shape of the snout, because the snout is going to be a real turning point for creating the actual character and personality of this creature. Because I try and build up significantly on these styrofoam bases so that they don't really have the same resemblance of what it was meant to be. But still has some sort of recognition, so there's a familiarity to it when somebody looks at it, but not necessarily as like, oh, that's what this is. Got enough Magic Sculpt on that for now. I'm gonna let that set up just a little bit before I spray my hands with some water to try and smooth out some of it. And I just like to smooth that out a bit It doesn't have to be anything major at this point, knowing that I'll be putting Magic Sculpt on top of it. Alright, the follow is showing up in the window. Thank you for the follow. Nora? Drew? Let's see. Aha, now it showed up. Came through my email first. That's crazy. Thank you for that. Alright, so let me spin this one your way a little bit. So, as you can see, I'm just slowly adding that Magic Sculpt to this ear. And if at any point I'm working on one side and I'm not thinking to spin it, just say spin that creature in the window, and I'll make sure to spin it so it's a little more visible. Sometimes it's a little bit challenging with the spin of the Lazy Susan and the positioning of the overlays of the windows, but I'll do my best to get it in your view at least a bit. So I did a test stream this morning just to kind of see how things were going, just make sure all of my cameras were working right. I got a new microphone in the mail yesterday that I hadn't tested out yet, and just to get things going, to make sure that tonight's stream should go pretty smoothly. Then I set my phone alarm to let me know like 10 minutes before go time, and for some reason it was totally muted and on a table not anywhere near me. So I hurried in here. Got things going. Okay, I'm gonna spray my hands. This is just a water bottle. It's got a little bit of buildup from me using Magic Sculpt, but it's just water on the inside. Normally I would spray it directly on top, but since, like I was saying, this is a paper base underneath, I just wanna smooth some of this in to the styrofoam just a little bit. And I'll really smooth this in later once we do that second wave. Okay. Right now these eyes are looking totally wonky at me. Gonna have to build that up soon just to give it some foundation and make it feel like it's on top of something. But first, let's take a look at this axe. So this axe, it was just a dowel rod. I cut this shape out of a piece of black heavy board that I usually use for presentations. And I also cut a notch into here so that it would sit in, so it would kind of have some sort of stability already built into it. And I'm just going to do the same thing that I did with the ears, where I do a little bit of a coil on each side so that it can grip on. And I'll let that stuff, I think for this, I'm going to let that set up a little bit once I get it on all four sides. Then we'll start building out some of the shape of the beastie, and we'll come back and put some more on this later tonight. And now Magic Sculpt will really bond to just about anything. If it's got any sort of porous surface to it at all, it'll really grip in good. I haven't had any problems with it gripping onto the styrofoam. So gripping onto this paperboard and also the wood itself of the dowel rod, it's just gonna grab on and bond super strong. And if anybody is watching and decides that they want to go out and try using Magic Sculpt, I would highly recommend wearing gloves. I personally have an allergic reaction to it. I know a lot of people that use it and nothing happens, but my eyes swell shut, I get all itchy. So, better safe than sorry. Alright, onward and upwards to this beastie. So, I know that the muzzle, it doesn't have this long, thin, and narrow coyote face. It's got a much, much beefier face. That being said, I'm going to go ahead and take two fairly similar sized balls of Magic Sculpt and start to block out the rough shape of what this critter is going to be. And so even with this, it's got this kind of open mouth look to it with the styrofoam form. But I know that's not what it's going to be with this, because I want this to have a much bigger face to it. So I'm just going to make it so this shape takes up the whole muzzle. So with this, it's going to end up using a lot of Magic Sculpt just to develop this overall shape, which is totally fine. Just means we're going to have to mix some more of this up quicker. But as we do this, we'll start to see the face and the overall personality of this guy come together in different ways. From one moment looking mean and evil to another moment looking sweet and like it's your best friend. And on this side, I'm going to have to make sure to bring it up over, almost like making sure that its lip is kind of curling up over the axe itself. And, okay. So this Magic Sculpt is just about done already, so we'll mix another batch, but first I'll blend all this in and smooth it together. One of the nice things about Magic Sculpt is when you are working in multiple phases, if something dries and is hard, you can put stuff right on top and blend it in with water, and no one will ever know that they were part of two completely separate sculpting sessions. But since I've got it here, I'm going to go ahead and spray it and smooth it down. Again, just plain old water. That's part of why I wear the apron when I'm working on stuff like this. It can just kind of drip down onto me and it's not going to be a big deal. If anybody is just hanging out and watching and lurking, thank you for tuning in. Feel free to ask questions about anything that I'm doing, technique, reasons I'm doing it, the world that I'm building. I'm going to get back to a normal streaming schedule as of next week. I haven't completely decided on the days yet, but it should be 3 days a week. At least probably through the end of the year, because I've got enough things that I can be working on and streaming while I'm doing it. Now I'm trying not to get too much up by the eye, since the eye is not completely encased in Magic Sculpt yet, and it does have paper in the back, so I want to try and stay away from that, even though I am spraying it with water close by. And right now also this nose that's on here is also out significantly further than the rest of the face, so I'm gonna have to bring the face up to that and build it up a little bit more as we continue to build this guy up. But you'll see that I just keep blending these pieces together, blending the patches of Magic Sculpt that I put on together, and just they smooth together. We'll get rid of almost all the cracks, even though most of this is going to be covered up anyway. So this creature has to be look tough, but it also has to be approachable, because this should be at their convention booth. So I can't have it look too fierce and evil looking. All right, so I'm gonna go in and grab some more of this. Doesn't really matter which one you start with. I grabbed with the one that's on top, and this time it is the hardening agent. Luckily, I have another bucket of this on standby to the other side, because we will most likely burn through all of this on this evening's quest. All right. So I'm gonna grab another batch of the hardening agent. If there's anybody in here that's watching that was not watching earlier when I was mixing up the Magic Sculpt, say something in the chat so that I will go through my spiel of how to mix the two together. Otherwise, I'm just gonna keep on working with it and not explain the process, since it was only 20 minutes ago or so that I did the last one. But if you're new in here, I'm more than happy to share again how this works. Just gotta shovel some of this out. They're almost equal in size. Looks like I've got more of the hardening agent left in the other bucket. Okay, I'll leave some of that in here. Again, sorry about the sticky stacky sound of it smacking around. Alright, so this will be, I need to have this done in time for Gen Con, because I will be delivering it then when I drive there, but I wanted to get it done well ahead of time so that I could have a good photo shoot done of it for the book that I'm working on, the art book. Currently I'm slating it for about 128 pages of photos and stories to go with the regions of my world and the different inhabitants that are in there. So I'll need to come up with a little bit of a story about the species of this creature and the character itself. Because this guy's definitely got some personality, or he will once he's all done. So he's going to need a little bit of a story to him as well. I should have grabbed a water when I grabbed my hot coffee. Couple more rounds of going back and forth with blending these together. As you can see, they are still two different colors in mixing this together. Still have a little ways to go on this. I may actually pop the eyes off and build things up a little bit more, I think, before I put the eyes back on, because now I'm starting to look at the shape and looking at how much I want to build that up. Might get in the way. It's one of the nice things about the difference between a three-dimensional piece and like flat drawing art. A lot of times this will change a bit as I go. But sometimes the magic sculpt wants to go where it wants to go. So now that we've got that pretty well mixed, let's go ahead and start building up a little bit around the face, around the eyes, so that I get a better sense of the placement and how they're sitting in. That way I can feel like they're a little less wonky staring at me. So I'm just taking chunks of the magic sculpt and just jamming it down against the styrofoam base with my thumb. We'll come back and we'll spray it with water in a little bit, smooth it down, we'll start putting some fur texture in. Fur, ever since I discovered this one rake tool, is one of the easiest textures and fastest textures to put in. Not to undermine what I'm doing, it ends up going by a lot quicker than you think it would. And so now I'm gonna lay down a little bit more magic sculpt here. And just to kind of get my mind in the mindset of the direction of the fur, I'm gonna start laying magic sculpt in a little bit in the direction that I imagine that the fur would go. And when you think about sculpting fur and the direction, the textural direction that things are gonna go in, usually want to take it in the direction that you would imagine if you were petting a pet at home, even if it's not anything like a pet at home. Like a lot of the weird creatures I make resemble nothing like a dog or a cat, but still you would kind of look at the shape of the head and think of how it would lay on one of your pets if you have one, or one that you've been around. And let's see. And drop a little bit more in here. Alright. Sometimes you just gotta say, spin that monster. And it's totally not in seed. Alright. I'm basically doing the same thing on the other side that I was with this side. Now I'm gonna put a little bit Magic Sculpt in here. Just along these lines. And jam a little bit more down this way. All right. And then gonna put a little bit along the top as well. Let's see. So I want this to be a little bit more, a little rounder on top, and bring up a little bit here as well. Anybody doing anything exciting this weekend? I think this is pretty fun for me, for not, I feel like I haven't sculpted a whole lot recently just because of all the other projects I have going on, so it's nice to be working on something like this. All right, I'm gonna bring the snout out a little bit more. And as you see, I'm just kind of laying down foundation pieces now, and it will all get blended in, and it'll all end up looking nice together in just a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and start figuring out the underside of this mouth just a little bit, so I know how much further down I need to bring the front, or the top part, the upper part. All right, he's gonna start getting some personality now. Here, and I usually like to work about the same amount on each side so that when I run out of Magic Sculpt, when I start doing textures and stuff, I can kind of carry it in a similar way from side to side. So I'm going to go ahead and drop a little bit on here as well, put a little bit more around the eye so that when I come in with some water, we'll be able to really give this some texture. Hey, beautiful Barbie, how are you? Is your evening treating you well? All right, so we've got some more foundation there. I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. Sorry, this is not gonna be super visible. Excellent. Let me know if you have questions about any of my sculpting or any of the weirdness that I'm making. Right now I'm just laying down the foundation of this this dog creature. It's a commission that I'm working on. Starting to get a little friendly look to him, I think, especially with the lower jaw being, right now it's a lot longer than what I did on the illustration, so I'm gonna probably bring this down a good bit on the top side, which is okay. I just need to make sure to work that in a bit. Sure, you can totally give me critiques. So I'm going to go ahead and bring a little, and but just bear in mind that it's a work in progress, and I just started on this 40 minutes ago. All right, so I'm gonna bring that up. And before I start smoothing this down or putting any texture in, I'm going to use up this last bit of Magic Sculpt. Is there anything in particular that you were thinking of, Barbie? Locking a little more in. And I'm gonna wait to do more on the snout until I smooth that down. And I'm gonna wait to build that up more until I start to get a better feel as to how that's looking. But I will go ahead and oh, gotcha. I could probably do that. I'd have to build a different Lazy Susan. Gotcha. Is it disrupting the video flow? All right. So now that I've got gotcha. Well, see if this works better, because I mean it's light enough at this point that I can do it this way and not use the Lazy Susan. So then I can just turn it this way, and hopefully that'll be fine. I'm spraying this just with some water. Also, this stand that I made is not completely level, so when I press down with a little bit of muscle on it, it'll kind of rock back and forth a little bit, so be prepared for that one. Usually with the really bigger pieces that I really need the Lazy Susan, because once it starts getting real top heavy, I have to put like a bowling ball behind it to kind of weigh it down in the back. Excellent. Any other initial thoughts? So just doing a little bit of water on here will help smooth out the Magic Sculpt significantly. All right, gonna keep smoothing this in. Well, the weight on the wood would then make me need to use the Lazy Susan, because it would be harder for me to turn. I mean, but I see what you're saying with that. I'm gonna smooth some things down on this side. Just gonna blend some of the Magic Sculpt in where I put couple layers together. I'm gonna put more layers on top of the axe. So this is right now, that's just a foundation to kind of get it to sturdy up so that I can then put more on top of this to build out to build it out. So that right now, that's not a big deal. Because I'm doing that as a slow build since it's got a paper base. I want that to kind of adhere to the wood. And then from there, I'm going to put a thin layer on top that I'm not going to really, that's not going to be the finish part, because I want that to harden up so that I don't bend or flex that kind of paper board underneath. But I like having that foundation, so it kind of gives me the base shapes that I cut out. Are you a sculptor as well, Barbie? Smooth this out a little bit more. Spray this down with some more water. So when I first started sculpting with this, I would just have like a cup or a bucket with some water and dip my hands in, and that was nowhere near as easy to use as a spray bottle. When I finally realized to use a spray bottle, it changed things by leaps and bounds. Gotcha. Totally get the ear thing, but I kind of like it being up a little bit more at the moment. If you have a chance, you want to post a link to some of your work in the chat. That way I can go back and look at it after it's over. I try not to touch my keyboard if I can when I've got magic sculpt gloves. But I'd love to go back and take a look later on. So a lot of times my sculptures, they don't always look exactly like the initial concept sketch. I tend to take a few liberties while I'm sculpting with them. Oh, right on. Cool. Also, try not to spray my computer that's in the background with the water as well. And just keep smoothing this stuff in just a little bit more. And then I'll determine if the shape, some of the shapes that I've got in here are to the point, like once I get everything smoothed in and cut in, I'll decide if I want to start adding texture to it now or if I want to keep building up certain areas. Most likely at the moment, most of it's going to keep building up, but there may be certain spots that I want to start putting detail in before it gets to the point that I don't like to work with it. Do you stream your sculpting as well? I've not been on Twitch in a little while. And I need to get back and start watching some folks. Just haven't had a whole lot of opportunity recently. Smooth things out around the eyes. Face is totally off right now, so I'm gonna build up more on top of it before I go in and start putting any of the details and texture in, because right now that it's very wonky in shape and size. So I'm going to build it up some more, and then we'll go from there. So with this, let's go ahead and grab some more of the magic sculpt. Again, if anybody's watching that wasn't watching earlier and wants me to give you a rundown of the mixing of the magic sculpt process, please chime in the chat. More than happy to share it. I just went through it at the beginning, and if it's the same folks watching that were watching earlier, there's no sense in me going through it all over again. And as I'm getting to the bottom of this bucket, it's just going to take a little bit more scraping to get things out. Camera is too low on the animal in the upper left of your screen. Camera's too low. This one, like that. Let me know if that's a little better. Cool. Got the resin, now I'm gonna pull some hardening agent out. Alright, they're about equal in size. So now that I've got these, I'm going to go ahead and coil these out. Sorry for the sticky sound as they smack against my gloves. Basically just gonna pull a long coil of the hardening agent. Then a long coil of the resin. Lego cup, you're getting some magic sculpt on you. And then going to take the two and twist and turn them together. Can't you pee? I don't understand what you mean. Then I'm just gonna twist and twist and twist and work these together. So as you can see, the two colors, the dark gray and the light gray of the resin and the hardening agent are still marbled in there. You really want to get a nice, clean, solid, consistent color in there. Gotcha. I have never tried mixing it in a pasta maker. It seems like a lot of work and cleanup. Hey, Cowpie, it has been so long. How have you been? Thank you for tuning in this evening. Sorry that I've been so far away and so distant. For me, the less I have to clean up, the better. Yeah, it's been months, it really has. I did a show in April, Spectrum Fantasy Art Live. And kind of ever since then, my whole schedule has been completely out of whack. No, I've never used a pasta maker except for making pasta. I've never used it with Magic Sculpt. But Cowpie, I do plan on coming back and doing this on a regular basis again. Damn, that's horrible. I'm sorry, are you physically okay from totaling it? And I hope insurance covered all the damages and stuff, but I know that's still horrible to go through. I personally have been doing great. Everything is going well. There are lots of big projects on the horizon. A lot of cool stuff going on with my art stuff, so all is good in my world. Alright, so now I'm going to kind of rough out some more of this face to get a better idea as to what I want this critter to really look like, and then that way we can start putting some fur lines in here and start getting some texture going on as well. But I do agree with you, Barbie, I'm going to bring this ear down a little bit. I'm not going to bring it down too much because I'm going to sculpt more inside of that after this hardens. It is a lot of work, but, you know, got to get some muscle somehow. And I'm much, I don't necessarily always clean my tools the best way that I should, and I would get a pasta maker all junked up. Oh, damn, I'm sorry, cow pie. I'm going to go ahead and blend this in as I go, just so I can see the cleaner shape a little bit more. And what I do tonight will not be the final, because I'll end up adding more detail to this and coming back and adding more layers. That's right. I just got to sculpt all the time. At least, like, my forearms and my hands will be rocking. It's the rest of me that won't be. New 30-minute magic sculpt workout. Before the accident, has life been good? Okay, side profile. This is starting to look okay. It's got a little too much of a like schnauzer type look that I'm seeing, so I'm gonna try and curve this up a little bit more in the front, and then we'll come back in and work on the nose later on. Yes, at least to me it is. I've known other people that do not wear gloves, but I learned the hard way after using it a handful of times. I kept wondering, why am I so itchy? Why do my eyes keep swelling shut? And then I realized it was the magic sculpt. So I wear gloves all the time. Excellent, good idea on the curls with the sculptures. Usually just going into a convention, carrying all my stuff helps with that as well. I think, also Barbie, I think I'm just more sensitive to some of the different materials, because a lot of different things that I touch, just like chemical type things with my fingers, I can notice tingling and stuff that I'm like, all right, I should be wearing gloves. I'm gonna make the bottom lip kind of come up around the outside, but first I want to create a tooth to go in there, so that's going to drastically change the overall face of this creature as well once I do that, because the personality will quickly change with that. I'm going to try and curve this in a little bit more, get it a little softer before we start putting some texture in. Do the other side as well. Knowing that there will be a bottom lip around the base as well. Yeah. Right on. Awesome. Congratulations on the high school graduation. What have you been doing over the summertime? Excellent on the kiln. Sorry about my head being in the way. Just turn things to look at it. Gotcha. When do you go in? To the service, that is. Gotta add some more on this side to kind of beef up this muzzle a little bit. I think part of it is, a lot of this is just too soft that I'm putting so much Magic Sculpt on top of Magic Sculpt. I think after I get this kind of roughed in, I'm gonna have to take a break on this part of it. Do some details, knowing that I'm gonna sculpt back on top of it, but so that there's some underlying details in case parts of it show through. And then just come back to this tomorrow once this stuff is hardened up. Because there's just so much mass of Magic Sculpt here that as I just keep moving and pushing it, it's like just moving this way and that way. So this will, Twitch will automatically record it for YouTube, so I will export it to YouTube either once I'm done, if I'm really tired at the end, it'll be tomorrow, depending on how I'm feeling once I'm done streaming. If you go to YouTube/TheBrianColin, I believe, that should take you there. Or Brian Colin Art, I can't remember. Or you could also just go to my website, Brian Colin, and then the link will be there as well. Gotcha. It's a giant step, Cowpie. Are you getting ready to call it a night, Barbie, or are you just asking in case you want to go back and watch part of it later? I also have some streams of some of my other sculpting up there as well. Alright, I'm gonna spin this guy again. I'll put a little bit back right on. Do you use a Magic Sculpt, Barbie? And if so, do you wear gloves? Alright, sorry that you're not seeing this. Let me turn that. Turn this creature. Spin that monster! It's basically just adding a little bit more cheekbone back to the back. Gotcha. I started with Sculpey, and then somebody suggested this to me, and I've used this ever since, just for the air drying factor alone, and being able to go bigger with it. Spinning this guy again. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just start putting some texture, laying down some Magic Sculpt down along the neckline. Yeah, I started out on like custom toys, like Kid Robot stuff, and so that's how I started using Sculpey, and I enjoyed it, but as soon as somebody told me about this, I was like, all right, this is my path. This I just want to get some magic sculpt in here, and then I'm gonna start putting some texture into this fur, some into the facial fur, do some lines in the face, even though I know that I'll come back and add more to it later. I'll probably after this figure out the tooth that's gonna be sticking up out of here. Maybe put down a little bit of foundation on the axe. We'll see. This up. So, Cowpie, have you been watching any new folks on Twitch since I've been gone? Swig of coffee. I'm gonna go ahead and put like a little bit of the start of like a tooth type thing that's gonna be at the bottom of this axe. Need to spray my fingers just a bit. So the foam is a taxidermy base, like somebody would get from a taxidermy shop. This one in particular is for a coyote. If somebody was to put a animal skin over top of it, a lot of the ones I get, I order foam bases and then sculpt on top. A lot of times I'll cut away at it or add to it. And then sometimes I just take dense foam, glue it together, and then carve away at it. But this one is one that I purchased the base form, and I try and add to it and build out the features enough that it doesn't look like whatever it was originally intended to be. Add enough to some of the different areas, but still have a little bit of animalistic familiarity to it. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little foundation of magic sculpt on the axe. Not a lot, just a little bit so that it'll harden up between now and the next session to give this a little more rigidness. And I'm just pressing it down gently with my thumbs, and then I'll spray a little water on my thumbs itself. Sometimes when I do the armatures, it's usually like I've done pieces where I get big chunks of foam and carve it out, and when I carve it, I tend to just use almost like a bread knife, just to get rough shapes out. And then when I have pieces that are extending out, I will use armature wire and build on top of that. But most of the, I haven't done a whole lot of full body stuff that would really constitute like using armatures to do limbs and things like that. Excellent. Gosh, I love Doug's work. I believe he's going to be at Gen Con this year, and I'm very excited to see his pieces in person. His works have so much personality and character to each one. And I think I've only seen Shannon once or twice, and I haven't seen her work around like I have Doug's. Yep. Usually, like, when I go to shows like that, if I sell pieces, then that, depending on how much I sell, it then warrants how much I can spend on other folks' art. So, hopefully I will sell some decent stuff before he sells out of his stuff. A little more to this blade. I'm gonna leave that for now. I'm gonna put a little bit more on this side of the beast. Then we're gonna start getting some water and smoothing this stuff down. Start working some texture in. Then we'll make some more magic sculpt. All right, water spray. And here I just want to kind of give it a decent smoothing, rough things out a little bit, knowing I'm going to add texture over top of it. And I'm going to cut up into some of the fur here, knowing that I want it to have kind of a little more wild flare of this top coat. Bottom coat underneath is going to be slightly different in texture, probably a thicker fur underneath. I want to try and smooth this up and try and get it as close to the wood on the back side of this as I can without really breaching over it, because if I go over it, then I'm gonna have to sand it down so it'll sit flush with the wood plaque that I'll make. Getting a little bit of an air bubble in here from pushing Magic Sculpt around. You just gotta give it a little jab, let the air out, and then smooth it all back down. And gonna spray this a little bit more. Okay, I like it having some slightly different shapes going in here. It's not super smooth and clean because I want it to feel more organic in nature. Spray a little bit up under here. Knowing I'm going to come back in and get that ear tomorrow. Okay, so since this is the oldest stuff on here, this is the stuff that's going to... Oh, got to get this axe smoothed out just a little bit. I don't want to spray it directly, but I want to give it a little bit of smoothing out, just so it's not so crappy looking, even though it's going to get another coat on top of it. Spin it so it's a little more in your line of view. Up just a little bit. All right, that will be good for now. That axe is going to be a lot beefier once it's done. But that said, I'm going to spray up around the eyes a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and get one of my favorite tools. I call it a shovel tool. Kind of looks like a gardening shovel or a spade. So. I think this one will work. I have another one somewhere, but I'm going to take one of my X-Acto knives because it's got a little bit of buildup on it. Let's see. As you should be able to see, it's kind of got a little bevel to it and a little curve. We've got to clean off some of the buildup real quick with the X-Acto. Because these are metal, I can just kind of shave off. No, I've not watched David Lemon. Is he a sculptor as well? And I'm terrible. I don't get, like, I've just now started being introduced to a lot of other artists just within the past few months at some of the shows I've been doing. And before that, I've been kind of living in my bubble. So if it's someone very well known that I should know, I apologize for being ignorant on that side of the world. The art world, that is. Awesome, will do. Excellent. Yeah, all the stuff that I've done has just pretty much been trial and error over the years as I've created more and more things and been like, oh, well, I like doing this, and oh, I could get a texture if I use this. So I can grab a rock out of the backyard and jam that into the magic sculpt. And so I can feel how this is starting to harden up just a little bit, a little more than I like it to be. Excellent, very good. And I've learned I've picked up a few tips and stuff at, like, I've gone to, like, this Gukon in Atlanta, the place that I get, like, silicone and resin from when I do mold making. So I've learned some stuff at their conferences, a little bit here and there, stuff that is generally applied to, like, mask making and things like that, but sometimes there's little bits, little tricks that I can pick up. So I'm going to use this rake. It is basically it looks like a little rake. I turn it on its backside. This thing is clogged up as well. I haven't done a whole lot of sculpting lately, and I didn't do a good job taking care of these, so I need to scrape off some of this buildup. But then I'm going to try and quickly take some of that into this muzzle snout just to give it some texture. Even though I plan to sculpt on top of it, some of that magic sculpt might end up showing through. So I don't want to have it have no texture in the final run. And I'm trying to take mental notes on these folks just so I remember to go and look at them. I will have to go back and read through the chat after the fact. All right, come on. This one's got a serious amount of buildup. That's one of the issues with Magic Sculpt. It does adhere really well to some of my favorite tools. And I'm sure there's mineral spirits or some sort of spirits I could use to clean these off better than me just scraping them. All right, that's good enough for now. All right, so I'm going to spray this snout again. I'm going to lay this down and start just pulling in the direction that I see the fur going on this beast. And I know this is not going to be the final grooves, but by putting these grooves in, when I go to paint it, it's going to paint super fast because I'm going to spray paint it black to give it that base prime, that dark coat, and then I'll go over top of it. And this is quickly going to add a whole lot of fur texture, and the light is really hot, so you're not going to see it here. Hopefully when I turn this around and I do the other side, you'll be able to see it pretty quick. And by bearing down a little bit heavier, it'll get slightly deeper grooves. And then I can also come back with other tools to get even deeper grooves for some of the more important creases. I just wanted to get some texture in, just in case, like, part of this ends up staying. Okay, let's do this side and see if you can see it as I pull it down. So I'm gonna pull it. I'm pulling in the same similar direction that I did on the other side. So I'm gonna have to twist it just to get it at a good angle. Yeah. Some of it's snapping back up in my face. Alright, gonna wipe a little of that off on my smock. So, is it Brian Colinart? So there's an issue with just Brian Colin because guy with the same name as me created the Rampage video game of the 80s, and he's super nice, and I've met him at Gen Con last year, but for a while we were always like trying to get the same social media handles. So yes, I should change the YouTube one, definitely. Okay, I'm gonna take this, do the rake again. I'm gonna do it all along this fur for now, just to get some base lines in. And this is not definitely not going to be the final area or the final go through, but it'll get it starting to feel a little more like it should. There should be a real URL with the YouTube. It shouldn't just be that weird name string number. All right, so it's starting to get some texture in there. Let's do the side a little bit. Actually, before doing the side, I'm gonna take this knife tool that kind of looks like a little knife, and I'm going to come up and do some just kind of waves and flourishy type things up in the area where the fur is coming up here. Just kind of separate it a little bit. I'll smooth it down. Basically, I just want to break it up so it's not just a clean line going through there before I start putting the fur in. And knowing that I'll be sculpting the underside of that in a little bit or tomorrow. Depending on how tonight goes and how the rest of the magic sculpt lays down. But I'll definitely take a look and figure out why it's coming across as just a weird string of characters and numbers and not a specific URL for the YouTube channel, Barbie. Doing a little more here, and then we'll start putting some of this texture in. I'm going to do some deeper grooves on this before I put the main fur lines in. I'm going to grab that same kind of shovel spade type tool and just put some deeper lines in. And then we'll come back over that with regular fur lines. And these I'm going to start pulling up from where I just put those grooves in. Spraying it down just a little bit more. This water is your friend once it gets to this point. I mean, it makes a world of difference when it's nice and moist on the surface. I'm going to go ahead and put a couple of lines into this little tooth thing as well. If I can get this at an angle that I'm happy with. Put a couple other specific lines in here, and then know that I'm gonna put even more lighter lines in with the fur, with the rake tool. All right. They cannot. I don't know of a way to do that. You can chat into the show. Task questions. Is there a way that you know of to actually do voice calls into the show? I mean, I guess I could set up something with a Discord and then have headphones on and hear chat through that. But right now it seems like a little more complicated than I'm ready to get into. Really? Awesome. How do you go about doing it? Do they call in while you're actually in the process, or do they call in ahead of time and like leave a voicemail and then you answer the questions once you're on air? So these little burrs that are coming up on here? So they call you directly and then you just answer while you're sculpting. Gotcha. Yes, I think like because of the limitations of my hands and the gloves, I don't think that's something that I would necessarily get into. At least at this point. Oh, gotcha. It could definitely be something while I was painting, if I needed to, because I have a Google Voice number that I could use for that. All right, so I think that is okay for now. I'll sand down some of the burrs at a later point. So what sort of show do you do when they actually call in? Starting to feel a little more realistic, a little more natural. It's going to take a little ways to go on this guy. Set the tools that I'm using up here so I don't mix them up and don't have them disappear. Right on. Time for another sip of coffee, then I'm going to mix up some more magic sculpt. See if I can get the same amount of magic sculpt out, or the same amount of resin out of the other bucket. I doubt it. So this bucket is on the empty, which is exciting because that means I've got another bucket next to me waiting to be opened up and ready for some love. I'm gonna tear a piece of that off because I don't think I have quite that much in the other bucket, but we'll see. All right, gonna grab this bucket for now. And put a lid on this. Yeah, this one barely has anything in it. Let's see what we can scrape out of here. Then I may have to go ahead and open up the bucket of the resin. Okay, I'm gonna pull a little of that out. Just gonna have to scrape a little out at a time. The resin definitely doesn't come out in one big chunk like the hardening agent does. Awesome. Very good. Thanks for coming back. You did not miss much. I've just been scraping the bottom of my magic sculpt bucket to get all the the bits and pieces, all the goodness out. So, when you last left this episode, I was asking, what sort of show do you do that people can call in for? Hey, True Jay, I give it about an hour max, the batches that I'm working in, where I'm comfortable working with it. After that, it gets a little tough and harder to work with, and I'm just not happy working with it at that point. And then usually I let it set up overnight or over a chunk of time, about 12 hours, for it to really harden up. I do not know the price difference because it's been, I want to say it was like 2008 since I bought Super Sculpey. Just because I did once I bought this, I just never bought anything else. So, True Jay, if you're new, I'm mixing up a new batch of Magic Sculpt. This is the hardening agent. Just worked it into a coil. Yeah, but don't you have to bake Super Sculpey? And this is the resin. Then you twist the two together. I twist the two together to start mixing them together. Yeah, so this, it air dries, and that's one of the benefits. I can go so big with it and not have to worry about trying to figure out how to cook it. Plus there's, like, I have not had any problems with this cracking at all. And I know that people have had issues with Super Sculpey being having some issues with being a little more fragile. I could see the heat gun though, but I don't know. I'd have to fall out of love with Magic Sculpt, I think, to give Super Sculpey a chance again. Magic Sculpt and I have a good relationship now. And in the grand scheme of things, I mean, this sculpture will probably take 4 or 5 hours maybe to do the sculpting part. Which I don't think is too out of line for the size of it. Excellent. Definitely wear gloves. Just because you never know. You can now get Magic Sculpt on Amazon. I still order mine from a taxidermy shop just because that's where I always ordered it from. They're about the same price. I just know the one place in North Carolina where I order it from, they ship it ground. It usually gets to me in like a day or two. All right, almost all the ribboning, marbling effect of the two colors mixing together is almost out of this Magic Sculpt. Gonna give it one more twist, and then I'm gonna start laying some down. Okay. For now, for what I'm going to do, let's see if I can figure out how to get this guy in a little bit better view. If I move some of my tools, shift things back a little bit. Try not to drop an X-Acto on my bare foot. No, not directly. Not that I've seen, anyway. Okay, so for now, I'm just going to start laying down more Magic Sculpt on the back of this guy to start getting that fur line in here. And this is still soft, so it will, if I bump into it, it's going to get dented, so I'm not gonna put any details or texture into that yet, and I just need to be careful, knowing that if I grabbed on this side where I've already started laying down some of the fur lines, it's gonna show. And let's see, what is the name of the company on the Magic Sculpt? It is MagicSculpt.com. And I honestly haven't checked there in a while to see if they actually sell direct. So there is that possibility. You know, I haven't tried heat to speed up the curing process. I know, like, the heat in my hands makes it more pliable. So I don't know if that would affect it or not. And I haven't looked on... I know they have some really antiquated-looking, like, forums or FAQs on their site. They probably have the answer there. I've heard of some people mixing batches and putting it in the freezer, but I can't imagine doing that just to have it all pre-mixed. And usually since I work in such small batches and then I tend to step away, I haven't really tried to like rush the process too much. Also, when I know that I've got like a lot of things going on, oftentimes I'll have like two or three projects that I'm doing, working in batches on. True Jay, do you sculpt as well? So I'm just blocking these chunks of Magic Sculpt down, trying to think of when my next streaming session will be. It will probably be... So I'm going to go for another probably 20 so minutes on this. Most of my streams are 2 hours, usually from 9:30 to 11:30 at night Eastern Standard Time. I'll probably be going to 11:30 this evening, and then that way this will give it a chance to cure up. But I probably won't be able to jump back on until Monday evening around the same time. Awesome. Well, it's lots of fun. If you do decide to and you ever have any questions, feel free to hit me up. I'm happy to share any and all knowledge that I've got. It is one of the most relaxing and enjoyable ways for me to make art. Yeah, sure thing. Alright, I'm gonna turn this thing around just a little bit to make sure I get the whole back, neck, and the head of this guy. It towards you a little bit more, see if you can see some of that. So you want to make sure that the entire thing is covered up. You don't want to leave any... If you're working with some sort of base like I am, you want to make sure that the entire thing is covered. Even if you're just going to paint over it, you don't want to leave anything open to any of the elements. Just slowly working this Magic Sculpt in and around the other parts, then I'll blend it all in with some water and then texture it up. Yes, let's see. Got it. I wrote it down. And I will definitely check that out either later this evening or early tomorrow before the rest of the house is awake. What sort of things does David sculpt? Excellent. I will. I will thank you for it. I just sprayed that with a little bit of water. Now I'm just smoothing what I just put down into one seamless blend of Magic Sculpt. This ear is slowly drooping down a little bit more, like in the illustration. All right, well, thank you for the suggestions this evening, Barbie. Much appreciated, and thanks for hanging out for so long and chatting. I will look at your profile later to try and see what you're streaming, and if you get a chance, send me the link to some of your sculptures like you talked about, and I'll definitely check out Mr. Lemon's work. Almost got the top smoothed in good. I think I can almost sit back down and get at a better angle on smoothing this part down before I go back in and start laying down the fur lines. Gotcha. Okay. Well, then tweet me the link like you'd said. Right on. Well, if you'd like me to call you something other than Barbie, just let me know. Spin this around, or no, I'm gonna sit down and start working on these up in here. All right, gonna put some lines up here and cut into this just to start getting some fur lines in here. Awesome. Very cool. Thanks, Frank. I will definitely check you out. I cannot touch the computer just yet, as with the gloves and such. I hope the rest of your night is filled with success. Right on. I will definitely give you a follow once I'm out of here. Awesome. Sounds good, Frank. I'll definitely check you out and figure out a way to get in touch. And I will be, I'm going to try and be streaming on the regular again, just because I've got a lot of projects coming up. Some of them won't all be sculpting. Some of them will be doing some flat acrylic painting stuff. But I'm going to try and be a little more social and a little less in my cave. Awesome. Thanks. I'm not going to be on too much longer this evening, so have a good night. Thanks for tuning in and the suggestions. All right, I've got to smooth this stuff out around the ear. And then once I get this done, then I'm going to start laying in some fur lines on this. Good night. All right, so let's see. Got that in. Let's make sure this is smooth. I'm going to go ahead and do this side first up top, because I have it, some of this blending in with some of the other stuff. And I want to make sure while that's still a little bit soft, it can all kind of blend together. Move my coffee cup that I seem to be spraying water into. Grody. All right. Need some more water on here. Gotta spin it just a little bit. Maybe it'll be a little better. Nope. Visuals on this part are not going to be as good as they should be. Here we go. All right, scraping some of that off a little bit, some of the gunk. Gonna switch hands. Try and pull this in just a little bit. And knowing that I'm going to come back in and add to this Monday, live on Creature Curation. All right. So I got all that fur laid in pretty quickly. We're gonna come back to the face tomorrow. For now, I wanna go ahead and put a couple of teeth in, knowing that I'm gonna build up a lip around the outside on the next go. So I'm just gonna make some basic teeth. Just gonna get kinda a little piece, roll it around till I get kind of like a little, almost like a little cone. Just drop those down on my mat down here. I'm gonna probably do a couple teeth on each side. Once I get the basic shape, then I'll jam them up to the actual beastie, and from there I'll put a little couple of details into it while it's soft. And the reason I put the teeth in now is then when I put the lip over top of it, like if I put them in now and then I build a lip over top of it while it's dry, it'll give it a nice little depth to it that it can't get if I try and sculpt it all at the same time. Holy, how does this song just repeat forever? All right. So I'm gonna take this bigger of the tooth. Okay, I'm gonna jam it in here. Gotta turn this guy towards me a little bit. Gonna put another one right near it. Alright, now I'm gonna spray it with some water. I'm gonna try and smooth it down just a little bit. And I'm going to bring in some tools to help me with this process in just a little bit. Let's see. I'm just going to get like a flat knifey looking tool just to kind of help shape this a little bit. Then I'm also going to take the shovel tool that I was using earlier. I'm just going to use this to help kind of press it down into this fur line, knowing that I'm going to be coming back over top of that with a lip. So it's not a big deal if it gets a little pressed down into it, because that's going to be covered up anyway. Then I'm going to do the same thing with this smaller one down here. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull this down just a little bit. Alright. That gave me a foundation there. I think once, I may have to build up on top of those a little bit once it comes time for it to be done, but that starts that out just a little. I'm going to do something similar on the other side. And I can totally see where I'm going to have to build that lower lip out. Let's see. Let's try and get this where you can see it somewhat. Nope. Gonna pull it all the way off of my desk. I'm gonna put these teeth in. I'm gonna spray them with a little bit of water. I'm gonna shape them a bit. Then I'll come back next time and do a little bit on top to kind of have some of the lip going over top of them. All right, I'm gonna take the shovel, just kind of pull this in just a little bit. Pull this in, that'll just kind of help press the magic sculpt into one another just a little. Blend that in just a bit. And know that I'm going to build over top of that next time. Now, just looking at it from the side profile, definitely needs, like, it is not rounded out enough. I think I'm just going to have to completely hide that nose and put a new nose on the front of it, but that's okay. I'm going to go ahead and I think I need to go ahead and build out. No, I need to wait. I need to let that sit and just kind of let it do its thing. I need to work on the face a lot, but I need it to dry. I was thinking I wanted to move in and add more to it, but I should refrain from that part. But so I will go ahead and start putting some layer of Magic Sculpt on the chest. And I think once I get this Magic Sculpt on, put some texture into it, I will call it a night. And then just finish it up on the next go. Okay, first thing, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna put a little bit of Magic Sculpt here to cap that off. That'll help secure it just a little bit. All right, laying down a little more Magic Sculpt here. And a little bit here. Then we'll smooth it all down, lay in some texture, and that will be it for the night. Anybody has any questions that's hanging out quietly in the background, please hit me up now, because there is a weird time delay, and I want to make sure that I am able to respond properly.
All right. Getting closer.
Ooh, my thumbs are getting tired. Alright, gonna give it another little spray of water. Smooth this out a little bit. And know that I'm gonna add to this next time. I'll go ahead and put some, go ahead and get some lines in here. I'll put some lines coming in this way. And I'll come in with the real fur lines in a minute using that same rake tool. All right, gonna come up with some fur, and then that will be that. I'm gonna tilt this guy up just a little bit so I can get a better, get a little bit better of an angle on this. Smooth some of this in, just a little bit into the base a little bit more. All right. This quickly gets fur going in. All right. That is going to be it for this evening. For everybody that has tuned in and watched my show, thank you, thank you, thank you. It is good to be back on the Twitch. Next time will be Monday night, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I will be continuing on this sculpt. Unless somehow I decide that I'm going to sculpt on it over the weekend, but I really doubt that's going to happen. Thank you for tuning in. Check out my website, briancolin.com, my Patreon, and I will see you next time. Until then, I hope the adventures treat you well.